Congratulations! We are at the end of this week. Let's just review the main points we have discussed. To write meaningful tests, we should deeply understand the requirements. The requirements are probably the most important artifact we can use during our testing activities. Requirements are often large, and we should break the requirements into meaningful partitions. Each partition represents a unique part of the problem. It is our job to identify all the existing partitions based on the requirements and test all of them. In practice, we can't test all the possible inputs that belong to a specific partition. After all, the total number of possibilities can be infinite. We then commonly choose a single instance that will represent that partition. And of course, if the partitions are well designed, any instance will serve this purpose, as we expect the software to behave exactly the same to any of the instances. In addition, we often make sure that our system behaves correctly when the input lies in between the boundaries of our partitions. After all, boundaries are a common place for mistakes. And finally, we learned some JUnit features that help us write several tests for different partitions. Deriving meaningful tests from requirements and thinking about all the possible partitions and boundaries is really challenging in practice. Make sure you keep practicing.